Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the negative binomial distribution. Today we will see how we can find the probability into the S spaces. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics. So what we have discussed that we will try to solve all those problems which we have discussed in our last class, that is a negative binomial distribution. So which is the linking at here. So that's a very simple. We will try to solve the various methods in this video. So you have to see firstly what is the statement is that if 0.40 is the probability of the children exposed to the certain disease, what is the probability that the 10th child exposed to the disease will be the third one? What is the meaning of that? So if you have these 9 and the 10 children, and this the condition is imposed on this 10th children is this is the third one which is catch with the disease. What is the meaning of that? You have to find the probability on the 10 at the 10th point, and the condition is imposed on that. What is the meaning of these 3 are there? It means out of these 9, the two more children are there who are exposed to the certain disease. But what about their position? It is not given to you. See, it may be the first children, it may be the 7th children, and so on. So it means whenever there is a problem such like this, you have to solve this with the help of negative binomial. So that's very simple. There are the two ways. So and make sure that whenever there is an equality sign, we work for the PDF. Whenever there is a sign of the greater than equal to, less than equal to, we will work of the CDF. How we can solve this into the SPSS? So firstly, I can show you. So this 10 is my input. So I can show you this is the first method. Okay. So what you can do is in the first method, this is my 10 is my input. So you can open your SPSS software, go to the variable view, define the variable as a X. Make sure that it must be numeric. If it is not numeric, you can click on here. You can change them to be the numeric. Now, what is your input is you can see again the input is my 10. So you can put here as my 10. Once you can click on this 10, now go to the transform, compute variable. Now, since my target is on the PDF, so you have to look about the P, that is a PDF here. Now, distribution is negative binomial, so you can search for here for the negative binomial. It's alphabetically G, H, I, J, L, M, so N. It must be the N are there, so it's a negative binomial. So where is the negative? This is there, negative binom. So you can click on here. Now you can see there are the 3 question mark. The first question mark is represent for my here. That is a quant. Quant means the target value as a 10. So by which name you have to store this value of the 10 into your SPSS is my X. So you can replace the first question mark with this value of the X. Second question mark is my thresh. That is a threshold parameter. What is the threshold parameter is? Is there any restriction on this 10 is there? Yes. You can see this restriction is my third one. There is a third child are there. So you can put the second question mark as my 3. Next one is my PROB, that is a probability. So what is the probability of the exposing the children is my 0.4. So the third question mark is represent my as a 0.4. Now you can save this output as a answer 1. You can press the OK. You can see now it's execute. So it means there is no error. Now this is the right answer of this. You can increase the decimal places. You can increase here ANS. You can increase the decimal places. Now the right answer is 0.064497 is the right answer of this. Second method is that what you can do is what we have discussed in our theory class is there. So what is that? Now there are the out of 9, 2 children are exposed. What is that? N is my finite. So whenever n is my finite, so which distribution will work? That's a binomial. How you can solve this? This is 9c2. How many are children exposed? There are the 2. That is a p square, q7. This is the probability up to here. Now multiply with this probability. So what is the meaning of that? It means you have to apply here as a binomial distribution. And this is the probability of the success. So I can write this same expression into the SPSS. What you can do is you can go to the transform. I can write the compute variable, press the reset. Now this is the binomial, that is a PDF of the binomial distribution. So I can search here as a PDF and search for the binomial. You can see here binomial. First one is a quantity. So what is the quantity in this case, in this parameter, how many successes you need? That is a 2. So the quantity is my 2 instead of this. I can write here as a 2. What is my second one is that n. What is the value of the n in this case? How many cases are there? There are total 9 cases. So it means the n is my 9. And what is the probability of that? Probability of the success, that is expose the disease, is my 0.4. This is the probability calculating like here. Also, we want to multiply this in terms of the p for the 10th children. So I can write here as outside bracket is multiply, probability is my 0.4. So I can save this. You will run this file, you will get the same answer as that of a previous one. So you can see, I can increase their decimal places. So you can see the answers are both same. So that's depending upon you whether you want to use the PDF binomial and then multiply, or otherwise you can use directly here as the negative binomial. So look at the another one is. So what is the probability that the sixth child? So it means if you have this here, the condition of the sixth child is my, it should be the second daughter. What is the meaning of that? Out of these five child, it means there is only one daughter is there. So what is the position of the daughter? It may be the first one, it may be the second, and so on. It means out of five, there is a one daughter. So I want to calculate the probability at the sixth. So my target is to write here. So if you solve this with the help of the first method, what you can do is out of these five, how many are there? One. So it means up to here you can apply the binomial distribution. Out of five, there is only one children, one daughter, probability of one, this multiply by the here. So this is the probability of the male child. So male probability is my half. What is the probability of the female? Again, 1 minus 1 by 2 is half. So that is my p. So what is that? 5c1 is my 5, half q is again half into p. That will be the right answer. And if you write into the spaces, what you can do is, so since my target is to find here, since this is the equality, so I need the PDF. So I can go to the here. I can firstly clear the screen. Okay, so I can input the value as a 6. I can go to the transform, compute, reset. I can search for the PDF and then search for the negative binomial. Click here. The first variable is replaced with the help of the x. What is the condition on this x is my? It should be the second daughter. So that will be my threshold value. So I can replace here as a 2. What is the probability of the daughter is 1 by 2. So I can save here as a. So I can click it. So now it's execute. It means there is no error. So you will increase the decimal places, say 5. So you will get the right answer as here. Also, you can try to solve this, you will get the same answer. Again, what is the meaning of that? You have to find at least 5 components. So this is the way. Now you can see this is the less than greater than sign. So it means I want this as a CDF form. So in order to write CDF, CDF must be as a less than equality. So I can write here as 1 minus less than 5, but we need the equality also. So how you can write as here is less than equal to 4. Therefore, I can write here as f of 4. This f is represent my CDF. This 4 is my input. And you can also see what is the condition is that it must have a 3 defective. So I need the 4 as an input. I can go to the spaces. I can define as a new variable, say y, and input as only values as a 4. So in order to get as a 4 as an input, I need as a 1 minus CDF. So I can go to the transform, compute variables, press reset. Now look at for the CDF here. CDF for the negative binomial. So CDF for the negative binomial, this you can click on here. The first one is replaced by Y. Threshold, what is the condition on this F5 component? It must have a 3 defective PCSP. So what is the meaning of that? I can go threshold as my 3. What is the probability of the defective is? It must have a 5%. So the probability is my 0.05. And also I need as a 1 minus expression. So I can write here as 1 minus here. I can save this here, say answer of question number 3. So you can see this is my question number 3. So I can save as answer as a 3. Press OK. You can see execute. So there is no error. Now I can see, now you can see it's exactly 1, but it is not the right answer. You have to increase your decimal places up to the 5 or 6. Now you can see this is the right answer of this. So if you want to solve it manually, how you, or this is with the help of the CDF. Second method is, if you want to solve this with the help of the PDF, how you can solve that? So in order to solve this with the help of the PDF, you need as a equality sign. I can write firstly this, and then I can write here. The question arises is why there is no need of the x1, x2 and here. Because if x is equal to 0, can you get the 3 defective? It means if you perform the experiment 0 times, can you get the 3 defective? No. If you perform the experiment 1 times, can you get the 3 defective? No. Performing the experiment means that is a component. If you take the 2 experiment or 2 component, can you get the 3 defective? No. It means the minimum you need a 3 components are there. Look at the another one is there. So since in this case, you have to find the probability of the 8th child. And is there any condition on this 8th child is? It must be the 4th one to be the infected. So what is the meaning of that? Out of these 7, how many are infected? Out of these 7, 3 are my infected. What is the probability of the infected is? 0.3. So if you solve this with the manually, so it means out of this 7, how many are defectives are there? 3. So this is the PQ4 multiplied by P is the probability of. So this is, that is a binomial up to the this portion and into here. Otherwise, now since this is the equality, so we have to use the PDF. This 8 is my input. So what you can do is you have to give 8 input as a here. I can define the new variable, say Q4. Input is my 8. Now I can define the PDF. Go to this, transform, reset it, search for the PDF, and PDF for the negative binomial. So I can search for the PDF for the negative binomial. The first one is replaced with a variable. What is the condition on this 8 is my? It should be the 4th infected. So this threshold is my 4, and the probability of the infected is my 0.3. So I can save this value as my 0.3. I can put up the answer as the answer 4. Press OK. Now you can see the execute is there. Now the answer is 0.07. But you can see if you select here, you will get the right answer on the upside are there. Also, you can increase the answer of the decimal places. So you will see the answer is 0.068068 is the right answer of this. So if you solve it manually, you will again get the same answer. Similarly, you can see the last example here. So you can see there are the 10 people are there, and the 10th person is believing on the rumor. It will be the 3rd one. That's a condition imposed on this. So what is the meaning of that? Out of these 9 people, how many person will believe? 2 people believe on the rumor. So how you solve it manually? This is 9C2, probability of this into the probability of the belief. And how you solve into the SPSS? This is the equality. So we work on the PDF. This 10 is my input. So again, that's a very simple. So I can go for you quickly, say Q5. I can input as a Q5, this as my input 10. Go to the transform, compute variable. I can PDF of the negative बाइनोमियल, पीडीएफ ऑफ द नेगेटिव बाइनोमियल रिप्लेस बाय द क्यू फाइव. वट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ दिस हेयर इज थर्ड पर्सन, सो दैट इज थ्रेश होल्ड इज माई थ्री एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ माई इन्फेक्टेड इज माई 0.6. दैट इज बिलीव ऑन र्यूमर बिलीवनेस इज अ 0.6 इज माई प्रोबेबिलिटी हियर. आई कैन सेव दिस एज आंसर 5. दैट इज द देर इज एग्जीक्यूशन आर देयर, सो आई कैन इंक्रीज द डेसिमल प्लेसेस सो दैट यू विल गेट द राइट आंसर एज हियर. सो 0.012740 इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस. 0.0127 इज द राइट आंसर फॉर दिस प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज द वे यू कैन सॉल्व इट इन द इन टू द स्पेसेस सॉफ्टवेयर. वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व दिस कंटिन्यूस रैंडम वेरिएबल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, दैट इज अ यूनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द स्पेसेस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. टिल देन यू कैन सिंपली फॉलो दिस लिंक फॉर फाइंडिंग द मोर अपडेटेड वीडियोज. बेस्ट ऑफ लक स्टूडेंट्स, हैप्पी लर्निंग.